Hello, good morning, good night, whatever it is for you. This is Cigar Review TV. I am your little host, Damon Pettit. And we are going to be doing, the El Baton Double Toro today. And see if you can see what that looks like. Nice little blue and silver band. Let's give it a cut. Give it a light. We're going to enjoy it. Kind of messed that up a little bit. This is a huge cigar. Thick, thick ring gauge. It's a 6x60. Let it whisk. Let's put with the whistle. Oh, thank God. Whew, very early in the morning, but I'm ready to get down to business here. We can only hope so, huh? There we go. That always worries me. This is a Nicaraguan cigar, 100% Nicaraguan, everything on it there. The wrapper, the binder, the filler, all Nicaraguan. The wrapper is the Corojo wrapper. Very nice so far. It's going to be extremely flavorful. When you have a that many layers of tobacco in there, it's going to have to be. I am wearing an old shirt, kind of commemorating the start of the football season. They got their little deal down, and so now the teams are all in action. There's been tons of trades. This is going to be a very detailed, well, cigar and also NFL review. How about that? My team, couldn't tell, was the Denver Broncos. Grew up in Denver, lived there my whole life for a long time. Been living here a long time now, but I'll always be a Broncos fan. And they've got a new coach. They have a few new players coming on. They have a good draft. And so it'll be interesting to see how they really do. I'm expecting them to have a better year than they did last year. But they may still need a lot of help. We shall see. Looking forward to the season, though. There are quite a few big pickups. A few of the notables is that Nadia Asamoah went from the Raiders to Philadelphia, which was that was a huge coup. Everybody expected who they were saying the whole time, Dallas or the Jets were going to be getting him, and then all of a sudden he signed with Philadelphia, so that was pretty cool. You got the Patriots making kind of a crazy move, in my estimation, getting Albert Haynesworth. I'm not a fan of that guy at all. I actually happen to kind of like Patriots. They've become a team that I've watched quite close for the last 9 years, 10 years now. And so it'll be interesting to see how he does there. That guy, I really, he's just, you know, he got signed a $100 million contract a few years ago and he was unhappy. So, you know, if $100 million in playing a kid's game, if you can't find a little bit of joy and just get on with your day, you know, fuck you. Sorry about that. I'll try to clean it up from now on. But then they did get a player who I do like quite a bit, is Chad Ochocinco. And he's a very colorful receiver, but he's very good. And he's a very, very good route runner. He's speedy. So that's probably a very good pickup for them. Some of the other big players seem to change. Philadelphia, they got Ronnie Brown from Miami. And who else did they get? They got somebody else that was... they picked up some players. Boom, boom. Oh, also Arizona picked up Todd Heap from the Ravens, which to me, I was very shocked to see him go away from there. But that's very good for the Cardinals because they got Colby from Philadelphia. And of course, Philadelphia also got a cornerback from Arizona. His initials are DRC, Dominic Cromartie or something like that. No. That's not right. Dominic something. So, that's that. This is very, very nice. I picked this one up to go on my trip when I went to Keystone a week and a half ago now, 2 weeks ago really. And fantastic trip. I really enjoyed it. You have no idea how fun that was, how nice it was. Massive river right behind us, beautiful scenery, and fishing was great. You know, when you're with your best friend and just hanging out, smoking cigars, drinking wine, watching movies, fishing, just hanging out, you know, how can you complain? But I picked two of these up, and we ended up smoking a lot of the cigars that Vince brought, but so I still had a couple of these left. Right at the end of the trip, I broke one of them out, started smoking it. I was running all around, kind of looking around, and it was the very, very last time we were fishing, so I was going up and down the stream, up and down and all around through these bushes, and this baby stayed lit the whole way. And I was very shocked because it's nice, it's built very nice. It did a great job, but I wanted to be able to go ahead and do a review on it on the show. So I figured I kind of know how it's going to be, so I'm not surprised right now. I'm not shocked by the flavor that I'm getting. It's excellent. But I wanted to at least do a review on it. And then, you know, I could also tell you how it performed. And, you know, being outside, there was a wind. That was another thing. There was a breeze blowing. And it just stayed lit the whole time. And literally, I was not puffing on it like every 5 minutes or every few minutes. I was walking around and all this other stuff. So, very impressed by it. It's a very economical cigar. I spent $6 for it. I'm sure that they vary depending on where you buy it, as far as the price. But, you know, it's known as one of the really good economical cigars. Oh, I love the coffee. And it is, it's fantastic, it really is. It's a J.C. Newman cigar. They also put out Arturo Puentes, and this is their one of their first lines that were not Arturo Puente. So pretty damn pleased. It's really, really good. You will definitely want to, it's especially like if you have a fishing trip, if you have just, you know, some place where you want to go hang out, if you don't mind a nice thicker cigar like that, pick it up, because it's definitely, it's going to last for you. Like I said, when I smoked it the other day, this was like a week ago, stayed lit, held an ash really well. I was outside, so it's one that you can kind of really depend on. Let's give you one more look at that. It says El Baton. It's kind of hard to see on there, but there you go. Anyway, back to some football. I mean, why not? It's going to be the start of the season. I'm trying to think of any other news as far as that goes. That's big. I think it's going to be a very interesting year. There are a lot of different free agents going to different clubs this time. I don't have any music going, do I? That's a shame. Let's see if I can throw some on while I'm talking here. It's almost... We'll have to do without the music today. Sorry, guys. A little out of practice. It's been like a week since I've done a show, and when you get off of vacation and you come back and you've been gone for a week, there's a lot to do. So finally back kind of in the groove and ready to keep doing some shows. So very nice. The my picks for a Super Bowl, see, my picks are usually, I try to make them as realistic as possible, but all you're doing right now is speculating based on the players, on the team, stuff like that. Some favorites have to be the Jets, the Patriots, as far as AFC. I'm sure the Steelers might be up there. They don't seem to have lost very many players. Kansas City might even sneak in there to be a competitor. They're looking pretty good. You got some sneaky people, some more free agent pickups, and I don't remember everybody that they got though. But Seattle, they picked up tight end from the Raiders. I can't remember who else. I think they might have got another receiver. They did. They got a Tavares Jackson, quarterback from Minnesota. They got a Rice, not Jerry Rice, but another Rice from Minnesota. The Broncos picked up Ty Warren, who was hurt all year last year, but he was a good player for the Patriots when he was playing. I believe he's been playing for either 6 or 9 years. He's an older player, but he's a good player. So we'll see how that works out. We see Super Bowl possible picks for NFC. You have to favor, you know, Green Bay until they are shown differently, because they won last year. then you're gonna have Philadelphia really vamping up, trying to look good. I'm not so sure about the Cowboys. You know, they're always kind of in there wanting to be favored, but I don't know about them. I think you might want to keep your eye on the Cardinals, just because they do have some new players that might really help out. They were a Super Bowl team a few years ago, lost a very good game, and then their quarterback retired, Kurt Warner, and so now they have an actual quarterback that they think will do the job. So if he does the job, their defense does the job, then they might be the team to contend with, mainly because all they have to do is get into the playoffs, and then any team in the playoffs can be dangerous. All you gotta do is win, what, 3 games to get in there? If you're a wild card, say 3 or 4, it can be done. So you never know with them, so you gotta keep your eye on those guys. New Orleans, they kind of had a disappointing year last year, but you know, they're still looking pretty decent. They traded Reggie Bush, which he went to Miami, and that was a little bit of a shocker, but that's how football is nowadays. And it's going to be very interesting. I really thought Miami was going to do really good last year. They didn't. They still have the same nucleus, really, with the exception they got Reggie Bush. They might have somebody else they got picked up. But, you know, I don't know. We'll have to see. So what do you think? Are you a football fan? If not, I'm sure this show just bored the hell out of you. Pretty much talking more football than I did of the cigar, but you know, I hope you don't mind. I just wanted to kind of chat with you, talk a little bit of football, since football is right there now. And let me know if you're a football fan. Who's your team? What are your picks? AFC, NFC. You don't have to give me your Super Bowl team unless you really want to, unless you're really hardcore and you think you know. Let me know. You just give me some teams that you think will definitely be in contention, and maybe even like a Cinderella pick, a pick that nobody thinks you know, are really picking or anything. Let me know. One of my picks, like I said, will be the Cardinals, Arizona. And I'm trying to just think if there's an AFC team that I could really think of that I'd like to pick the Broncos, but I'm being realistic. And I don't see them getting to the playoffs this year. I hope I'm wrong, because that's my team. But we'll see what happens. So, that's that. We got the El Baton cigar, we got some football, and some smoke, and some sips of coffee. It's good to see you. Thank you very much for watching. The fact that you watch it all is just really, it's great for me. I really appreciate it. And I just hope that, you enjoy it as much as I do, because I'm going to keep doing it. But I'll be seeing you in a couple more days. I'll be doing another cigar review on CigarReviewTV.com. Stop by my website. It's still somewhat plain, and things are coming around on it, but, you know, I think a lot of people watch this thing mainly through YouTube, but we'll see if we can get them to go to my site at some point. It's not going to be commercialized. I'm sure I'll have a few commercials on there, but you don't have to click on them. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. Go out there, get a good cigar, spend some time with some friends, talk about football, talk about fishing, talk about chess, talk about life. and enjoy some life. We don't know how long we got, so enjoy it while you got it. Spend time with the people that you love, people that you like, and have a good time. I will see you soon. Thank you again for watching. This is the show. Bye-bye.